When I ask people if they would like to retire, the answer is usually yes. In fact, it's 99.9% yes. Yes, they want to get out. I want to get out. And then I ask, well, into what? And I often hear, sleep in, travel, and play golf. Then I say, then what? Where will the purpose and the fulfillment come from? And I know there's a couple of you out there saying, what? More fulfillment than golf? This guy's crazy. But no, there is more fulfillment than golf. Well, as you know from today, the number one question in retirement circles is, do you have enough money for retirement and the lifestyle that you want to live? And of course, who will manage your money? But it's the next questions that we're going to talk about now. What are you going to do with your time in retirement? What are you going to do when you wake up? Who are you going to be when your career identity is gone? Saying that I'm a retired teacher or a retired nurse or a retired cop means that someone is afraid to let go of their past identity, and for good reason. Letting go of one's identity is scary, as I said at the very beginning. Mine was really scary. It's scary until you transition to a new identity. So I want to talk to you about your transition to a new identity. I mean, unless you're going to continue in your same profession until your very last breath, you're all going to go through this reinvention process. And most of you will do it unconsciously, but I recommend being very conscious about the transition process. And that means knowing how these transitions happen. Well, I happen to agree with the work of the late William Bridges, who developed the theories of transition. There are three phases to transition.